Hello, everybody. Welcome to Geordie Gore's second game of the season. Up against some Dwarves. He's got three Mighty Blow, he's got three Guard, he's got a Strength guy, but he's only got 11 players. So hopefully the Claw will absolutely fuck him. I'll just get lucky and fuck him up with the Claw. That's the plan. Got three Guard of my own. Got a couple of Strength 4 guys. I'm going to sack this guy soon. But I figured, seeing as Dwarves aren't afraid to minus two dice people, or one dice them if they can, it's worth keeping him with block just for one game, even though obviously armor rate is terrible and I'm definitely going to get rid of him. He'll probably get the MVP just to fucking punish me. 13 players, so, no, 12 players, so, you know, I'm not going to foul with 12 because Dwarves are fucking rowdy as fuck. Right, let's go. I didn't sack my 10k because it didn't matter. Yeah, the XOR, that's why I didn't. I looked at how much he had in the bank, how much he was getting, and the 10k just didn't matter, so I kept it just to give me more options after this game. Yep, that was why. That was why I didn't sack that extra 10k. He just gets a babe, which obviously with Dwarves is hardly anything. Could he have got the... Could he got Far Blast? I think I would have got Far Blast if I was him. Because I guess I might knock people out, but even then I'm more likely to cast them than knock them out, aren't I? So I would have got Far Blast if I was him, just for an extra player. Mastini. I actually am Pedro Jack, believe it or not. I passed the Mensa test, but I didn't. My friend paid for the test and he got buy one, get one free. So I went to Newcastle and did the test with him. And we both passed, and he became a member of Mensa. But I was like, I'm not gonna pay money to say I'm a genius. I think that's like the opposite of being a genius, isn't it? So, I didn't. Right, do I just receive the ball, hope for a 1-1? Of course I do. And I shall turn off my face, so I'm not under pressure to act. Mm-hmm. Not stupid. Yeah, the Furrow Claw Mighty Blow. I mean, it could be good, couldn't it? It could be very good. I like introducing the Trollers off. That's a big reason to not have it, you know? That's a big reason to not take the Troll on your roster or the Beast of Nurgle, because in these matches, when you're 500 TV down, if you just get to induce a Troll, it's not even bad, or a Beast. Oh yeah, Ripper's obviously amazing. Ripper's really good actually for 270. But even just a normal Troll, yeah, it's not bad. I think I probably should have gone Necro in UK BBL. Just because like these games when I'm 700, well okay, 700 is a bit different. But in that game I was 450 TV down. 450's a Wizard and Chaney, and that gives you a shot, doesn't it? But with Chaos Dwarves you're like, they don't have Hathark. What am I even doing here? BL, BLGF. Best of luck, good friend. That's definitely what that means. I'm not hyped for Amazons. I mean, I'll play some games with them. You know, I'll play games with all of the teams. But fuck, I was gonna put this guy here. I guess I still gotta do it to get three dice. Maybe get a knockdown against Dwarves. Yeah, banged on. Got a hit and run, haven't I, with a mighty blow? Oh god, I'm not gonna even knock him over. Didn't even fucking knock him over. Jesus fucking Christ. Story of my life. Fucking shithead dwarves, I hate them. It's the worst possible matchup. I should really just concede. Oh yeah, the 4-minute turns from hell. Right. At least I got the ball anyway. Nobody died getting the ball. Failed the fucking knockdown with four dice. Maybe I should try to set up to get three dice. Blub skills McBlub says Gesundheit. Blub skills McBlub says Gesundheit. I guess I should have done that. I'm not German, so I just forget.
He's unfriending.
Whoa. Yes, Brandhill. Yeah. It was, I wouldn't say it's a great matchup, Pedro Jack, at all. Are you ratched? It's Dwarves. It's not great at all. At all, because your zombies are shit. So it's just all about your positionals against his, isn't it? That's the thing. And like, sure, I've got my whites are pretty good with guard, but he's got mighty blow. He's getting his mighty blow digs in all the time. He's gonna completely. I guess it's good that I've got three guard, but he's gonna dominate and he's gonna make frenzy traps for me with his guard. So a strength three, like obviously claw mighty blow is good, but he's gonna straight away two dice him with mighty blow right now. And you might just fucking smash me to pieces. Oh, hello, VIP son, I hate you now.
Hello.
You know, it's like, this is the thing, it's just fucking... And they can lock you down, it's not favoured at all. Like, obviously, if the Necros get lucky. Yeah, but it's not ideal. It's not the ideal counter, is it? Because he's got frenzy. It's a double-edged sword. If he didn't have frenzy, I would have got the pushback and been here and not being hit by mighty blow. It's good that he's got 11 men. It's good that I've got a chance, but it's not a good matchup at all, and definitely not a great one. I don't even think it's a good one. Honestly, it's like, I can't apo the wolf. You can just easily knock him out. He's only armor 8. All my hopes are pinned on getting lucky removals. If I don't get lucky removals, I just get banged on. There you go, straight away. KO'd. I told you, Pedro John. I told you. There you go. Not looking like a great matchup now, is it? It's 170 TV on the bench. Thank you. Might not even get him back. Now I'm just going to mute myself and suffer through this game in silence, I think. Well, it's easy to say that now, yes, Carlo Ancelotti, but of course, you know, 1 in 3 times you get banged on and you do that, don't you? So I've played people and they dodged away and then Cavs themselves dodging and then it looks stupid, isn't it? And it's really not ideal. Ideal counter is a claw mighty blow piling on strength 4 guy, not a fucking strength 3 guy with frenzy who fucks himself. Thank you. Didn't see the guard, fucked myself. Oh, right, I'm just gonna turn off the camera there, like for the rest of the game. Nobody counted as dwarves really at low TV, just at high TV. The agility teams run rings around them because they just don't get faster. And obviously I'm not gonna commit the reroll. But it does dictate where he blitzes though, doesn't it? And he might use a reroll up and he might not get killed, you know? It only looks bad. Look, if he fails a dodge and gets knocked out, I look stupid for dodging. If I don't dodge, plus I hadn't picked up the ball at that point. So, you know, then the ball's on the floor, then he maybe just gets, you know, he might be banged down. Maybe I dodge, he gets knocked out, then he blitzes him and knocks him out, and then he's all over the ball and I haven't got the ball. So, yeah, at high TV, the agility teams get more, like, skills and run rings around them, or one turn them. And the Chaos teams and the Nurgle teams just claw the fuck out of them. But at low TV, there's no counter, really. You know, well, I guess Lizards are the closest just because of all the strength, you know. But anyway, yeah, you'll have to enjoy it without commentary because fuck Dwarves. And that's why you've got to sack flesh golems to get minus AV. Yeah, there you go. That's what happens when I make a dodge. Brilliant. Yeah, it kind of is, Nixon. I know I should have the fucking camera on and the mic on all the time, but it just... I don't know. Like, this game, I don't want to fucking play this game. Jesus Christ. I fucking hate leagues. I fucking hate this league. I'll fucking see out my games in this and UKBB. I think I'm going to quit them both. I think I'm going to quit them both because it's a fucking baller schedule. And I can't win the league for fucking 8 months anyway. What the fuck's that about? Why do I want to play in a league where I can't win the fuck, do anything for 8 fucking months? It's an absolute fucking joke. Yeah, I don't hate matchmaking, I just hate the fucking TV gaps in matchmaking. All they've got to do is just get the res in, and then you can have res matchmaking, if they had res matchmaking, and res leagues, it'd be amazing. Oh man, my Garchomp comes in, protects against the hidden power ice from Zerkatree. Fuck you, Zerkatree. Glorious. Won 20, lost 8. Sheffield Steelix, unfortunately. I've misplayed a lot. One game I felt like I couldn't win. And one game I was horrifically unlucky. Completely horrifically unlucky one game. But the others were all misplays by myself, to be honest. So, I mean, this is exactly what I wanted, of course. He's fallen into my trap. What I wanted to do was score in 5 turns. Gives me 3 turns to turn him over again and get 2-0 up. That's exactly what I wanted to do there. To be fair, it went that well. I've stopped battling. Right. I don't know anything about a GOG tournament. I think I'm going into more tournaments though. But I think maybe I should have got something like a Gigalith or something in the team, you know, some kind of weather. I looked at the top 10 teams on the ladder, and it was outrageous. 8 of the top 10 had a weather setter. So I nearly didn't even blitz with him, you know. I was nearly, because obviously it's set up to protect his guys from getting blitzed by it. So I thought, I've got a blitz even on the LOS. And, I blitzed specifically so I could run him away after I got the knockdown. And, frenzy players that get jugs. Come on. I don't know what frenzy players are they. Berserkers get it on normals. I guess I'd get Juggernaut on normals. I'd get Juggernaut on normals for Troll Slayers. I get Juggernaut pretty quickly. I go Mighty Blow, Piling On, and Juggernaut. But a Witch goes Mighty Blow, Piling On. And obviously, Werewolves go Mighty Blow, Piling On. Proud Nine Dramper. Mm. But I just thought, you know, seeing as the others, 8 out of 10 have a Weather Setter. So, I thought it's worth having a weather setter. The top team, in fact, has 5 of the same Pokemons as me. And then, and their 6th one was the bastard who does the ice stuff, Ninetales, Alolan Ninetales. So I thought, I've gotten Ninetales with the egg moves and the hidden ability. So I could, in a Wonder Trade, thanks Wonder Trade. Yeah, because I killed somebody. That's why Carlo Ancelotti. I killed somebody. And I was like, fuck you, Barcelona. Do not use, get a block, get a free block on this guy, thank you. Get sweet revenge. Oh no, he doesn't have to follow, does he? Duh. He's got guard, hasn't he? Pokemon Sun and Moon Sledger, and I made a battle team. I'd like to be competitive battling, you know. I've had a few games on Pokemon Showdown. I think I'm going to start playing more. I do like Pokemon, and now that I've got the 3DS, you know, I think. Yep. Yep. Thanks to Senai, she got Sun, and I was pretty jealous for her. Oh yeah, got Moon, and I was pretty jealous for a while. And then eventually I caved and I got Sun, and it's pretty good. And now that I've got a DS, do you know what, I didn't realise that Black and White was on the DS, and I had a DS, like DSi or whatever, DSi, XL, whatever the fuck it was, and I didn't even realise. Sun is on the 3DS. But I didn't realise that Black and White was on the DS, and I could have just played Black and White and never did. Crazy, yeah. But I had what was it? Obviously Red. Pokemon Red, Sapphire, and then I had like Pearl and Platinum. No, the thing is though, the Pokemon scene is just all old nerds, a bit like Bloodbowl. So it's not so much picking on 8-year-olds, to be honest. You see, this is why the claw isn't even good. He's gonna have to dodge. And you know what I mean? Like, unless your opponent's an idiot, they set up to counter your fucking wolf players, obviously. Which is why a lot of people like a Mighty Blow White, so you can do the players, the sensible players. It's pretty similar to Bloodbowl, I guess. It's very niche. It's very niche, isn't it? Pokemon battling. Oh yeah, Heart Gold and Soul Silver. I've got DSi XL. Sounds like a sports car. It looks like one. It's sexy as fuck. The DSi XL. Holy shit. Oh, yeah. It's like the sexiest handheld gaming console ever made. It's unbelievable. Yeah, so I don't know. I think I might do some. So I might even get a capture card, depending on how expensive it is. I might get a capture card and stream the best Pokemon battles the world has ever seen. But it's just the thing is, it's so fucking deep that I might not bother. It's scary deep how deep Pokemon is. And it makes, like, you know, once you go down the rabbit hole, as Combat Bunny would say, next turn this guy can be the Canoring threat, can't he? You just go, see you later, dickheads. That was a funny touchdown score, wasn't it? Holy shit. Click on end zone, win. Oh, this guy can just go up, in fact, he can be the Canoring threat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, GFI. I mean, you'll have to make one GFI next turn. Hang out over here. Pretty much Ducky, yeah. To be fair, though, Sun and Moon's so much better than the old one was. Like, the last time I'd played. Why did he blitz from there? Oh, so you can push there for two assists. Yeah, fair. He's fucking stopped the old Canoring threat get out, hasn't he, little bastard? He's got a Canoring threat of his own down here as well. Yeah, last time I played, which is like, what, Pearl and that. Yeah. But the Sun's so much better for, like, hatching good Pokemon. It's so easy to do. Like, I've spent hardly any time with Wonder Trading and the fucking Destiny Knot and the thing in the PC to check the IVs. It's just fucking easy as fuck to do. It's brilliant. Yeah, Gary Speed. Legend. Didn't I do some kind of crazy chain push here? Like, what I'm thinking is, bear with me on this. Blitz him two squares across, then block him into the thing. Right, where's the guard? There's no guard here. Or even him. Nah, he'd be too hard, wouldn't he? There's a guard here, so I'd have to have my guard. I don't know, he's the one who's going to do the block. Could blitz him two pushes. Then put a guy in here. Block him out of there. To there. No, because he's fucking there. Maybe don't do that. What should I do? 2D him. 2D with block. That looks good. Oh, could block here, couldn't I? And then I'll block here and then run around the back. It's too far to get around the back, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, no. Face the ball carrier. That's what all the pros do. I just fucking hit him. Fucking shit. Got a knockdown. I'm still in attack zone. Fucking bad. Get a knockdown here, that'd be the sweetest thing in the world. Sweet! Get him in there. Or here to get another knockdown. Or go around the back. He might switch to this guy, mightn't he? I can just go here to get this block. Fuck dwarves. Alright. Canoring threat. Activate. Espria taking players off just like real life. He doesn't care about the match. He ain't tackling anyone. He's just trying to get a touchdown. Hello, Inarian. No, I've got no idea. No idea. I don't think he has an idea either, does he? He just gets somebody to arrange all his matches for him. Holy shit, the giant from Game of Thrones died.
What?
The giant from Game of Thrones died. 36-year-old. The UK's tallest man, 8 foot tall. The fuck? 7 foot seven. It looks, why does it look like 8 foot? why is he up to the 8 foot mark? Oh, that's stupid. 7 foot seven. Holy shit. Tall, isn't it? The Facebook group, the Tall Persons Club, paid tribute to Mr. Fingleton, saying that Neil Fingleton, Britain's tallest man, passed away on Saturday. That's not really paying tribute to him, is it? Holy shit. Yeah, Bill Paxton died as well. Yeah, holy shit. Game over, man. Thank you, Jester. Gonna have to make a 1-9 here. It's shit that I let him mark the one with dodge with tackle. You know, and the one without. Maybe I shouldn't have gone here because he was in range of his 5 squares. That's a stun, just realised. That gets him up somewhere. GFI, then he could block him to get the assist to make it a 2D. Oh, and he's got him too there. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. GFI. You can block him. Yeah, still not too bad. Don't even think a red dice in me, you cunt. Get the fuck down, dwarf bastard. Shit, he gets a push. Right. Oh, it's a one dice now because of him. Okay, he blocks him down. Easy. Now he blocks him down. Easy. Alright. He has to one dice him. It's a 3 plus, it's not that bad. I've seen this work in the movies. Alright, good. Easy. Two dice block, and it gives us the assist. And this is a two dice into a two dice. That is the absolute point, Carlo Ancelotti. That is the absolute point of the Canary threat, yeah. That's why it's a meme. Because it's obviously fucking dumb to have a guy trying to score when you should be trying to fucking stop the score. That you have got the essence of the meme there. Well done. I mean, if I'd just based his guy who didn't have block, had tackle, to let him be one dice, he wouldn't have got there and everything would have been a lot easier, wouldn't it? I wouldn't have had to tag him with him. You'd already been tagged up over here. He could have come back tagged him. I'd made some nice rolls there, didn't I? Yeah, well, he could have scored. The long beard could have scored, but obviously didn't try. Had to try. 1, 2, 3, 4, GFI, GFI. No, he can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, GFI, GFI. But yeah, he's only in that position because I did the stupid canoring threat. So there you go. If I hadn't done that stupid canoring threat. You pushed him the wrong square, oh my god. I bet he's regretting that right now. Like, why did I push him there? Holy shit, gave himself an extra 3 plus roll. That would have been funny and just as colorful at the year. To be fair, it might have been the bug where the auto choose where you push. I didn't see which angle he puts from, but it could have been Cyanide's fault. I'm missing two of my best players as well, the two block guarders and two agility threeers. Pretty huge two players to be out. If I was down two zombies, it would have been pretty bad. I mean, pretty all right, but still. I mean, to be fair, I didn't have anyone stood up for half the fucking half, so. Yeah, I guess I've just got to minimise blocks here and hope that I can hit and run with this guy maybe a little bit. Shit, there's the two whites. The two guarders out. Pretty bad. Wow, unbelievable. His armor 8 wasn't broken. Call the cops. I guess I should do, yeah. Can't log on. Maybe I should, but maybe that's why Kanor does it, eh? Maybe that's why Kanor does it. He's got 3 guard, I think. Looks like he's only got 2, doesn't he? No, he's got 3. 2 there, 1 there. He's got 3. I thought there was 3 in the team preview. It's just everything gets fucking mashed together, doesn't it, with dwarves? That's how I didn't see the guard, you know, on the turn that I one dice blocked. Because I was, like, zoomed out like this, and I was like, oh, there's one guard. So I've got to remember to zoom in a bit. Because fucking dwarves have got too many fucking skills. One's Kazd and one is KO. Not good. One guard here, could put in my own guard there, but then can't hit and run. So he's not letting me hit and run on any of his things. I'm not about to commit a reroll to a fucking dodge. And tag him, can't cancel that. And give him 2 assists. That the wrong square because I thought he could move forward. Not on my best form here. Is he stand up? Guess not. Right, hopefully just gets a million bolt pounds against this fleshy now. Right, stun there is pretty nice, isn't it? Fuck it, I'll stand him up just to take somebody away from the action. No, it depends. I stay puffed. If it's in a league, then I would buy a troll. But if it's not, then yeah, stadium enhancement. Because you know, in matchmaking, it just brings you that much closer to claw. Stand him up just to get. Oh no, not stunned. I just imagine every time I stand up a player like that, he'll just get stunned. But it did. It did keep a guard out of the at least one guard out of the way for a turn, didn't it? Actually, basing two out of his 3 guards is a pretty good use for that zombie to get knocked over. Yeah, you could get a troll and a goblin. The one turn isn't that bad. The throw teammate. Come on, both down on every block now against this fleshy. Scheiße. Straight in for the knockdown first time. Would have broken his armor anyway though, because it was a 10. Fucking hate having an armor 8 fleshy. I'm going to get rid of him straight, well, after this match. Everyone does I stay puffed because they've all got loner, haven't they? And they've all got loner and no block. So everybody has terrible luck with big guys. It's pretty hard not to have comparatively terrible luck with big guys, isn't it? Either, to be honest, VIP Red Joker. Either. I was trying to keep my players alive, but apparently had 2 stun. So, I don't know. I don't know what I'm trying to do. I mean, I think dwarves are so slow that you've always got to try to stop them scoring if you can. Just because it is. Just because you can do it, you know? Just because you can make them potato and outrun their protection a little bit sometimes. I'm just looking to get fucking claw hits, but it's really fucking hard. It's really, just really hard. All I want is claw mighty blow hits. And he's just not, he's not giving them to me. No, I have terrible luck with him though, Draz, because you just roll a one for him when he's got to go somewhere. When the people just dodge away from him and knock him over or push him back or whatever, then you gotta roll 2+ to activate him, you roll a one, and he's fucked. And you're fucked. Exactly, Carlo Ancelotti. That's exactly what happens with mine. And again, it's because he's got, ooh, wait a minute, I could push him. No, one, two, I'd have to dodge. I'd have to chain him. I'd have to put a guy there, put a guy here, block him, chain him out, then one, two, three, four, five, six, two GFIs. Oh, that's outrageous. I just got up the two. Does have another one there. GFI, I probably should have done everybody else first. Lucky me. that's pretty awesome, Steelix. And even then, when he pushed forward when I had the ball, he sandwiched the ghoul, didn't he? So it was like a 4+3+0 and stuff. Yeah, he's played very well. He's absolutely stopped me two dicing. He's stopped my he shut down Werewolf blitzes, hasn't he? It was Noamto. The thing is though, BM cards, it's sweet for him too, because he's got the fucking two troll spheres, hasn't he? Four, three. Oh, there you go. Thank you, Crumsley. So there you go. So, I mean, he couldn't have done much more than that, could he? 4-4-3. No, I think he only had tackle on the first one. I didn't look, but I knew he had tackle on the first one, but I don't think he did have tackle on the others. Because I think it was next to a, I think I ran next out next to a blitzer. So. I'd really like my my flesh golems to be pushed and not just removed. It's hard, isn't it, against dwarves when you lose all your players and they lose nobody. I mean, I've only made like two claw mighty blow blocks, I think, in the whole game. No, three. Three claw mighty blow blocks in the whole game, and I think I've got two stuns and a pushback. Pushbacks on one time. The time I made two stuns. But yeah, he's done a very good job of stopping me. Stopping my claw mighty blow. Now I've just got to go for a probably a stupid one dice if I can even get it. Because I've got no guard because he removed it.
He's.
Thank you. Frenzy's fine if they're strength four, you know. That's why I said it's better than Mighty Blow on a wolf, you know. I think a wolf is the best. When Shaver got his plus strength wolf, I think it's the best player in the game to get plus strength on, because strength three Frenzy, especially with Claw, because you really fucking want to be hitting people with him. You really want to be, and obviously Chaos Warriors are armor 9, but strength 4, and like big guys, you want to be hitting, generally got more armor, so you kind of want to be hitting the stronger players with them. And the fucking strength 3. He's let somebody up here anyway, at least. Maybe. Yeah, edge 4, but still, I'd rather be strength 4. Just stand these fuckheads up and then watch them all get knocked over again. Maybe he's trying to rope-a-dope me with this play. But, I'm gonna do it anyway. Why not? It's Block Mighty Blow, isn't it? Claw Mighty Blow. Gets to hit me with Mighty Blow, probably kills me. Yeah, it's true, he's got a lot tied up now. He's only got 4 players free. Against my 4-3 ones. Exactly, Mantle. That's the thing, isn't it? The claw, the horns on Beastman's just really good. They don't have Frenzy. And they've got Strength 4 Blitzers. Strength 4 is so much better than Strength 3. And then Frenzy is really bad with Strength 3. But if it was Strength 4, the Frenzy would be alright. But still, it still would be not, maybe it's not the best thing to have. Thank you very much, man kids. Thank you very much. I'll try. God knows I get salty sometimes. I guess I've got to stand firm here so he can't assist this bitch. Holy shit, he finally rolled pushes against a fleshy. And that's the first time in the match that he hasn't knocked down a flesh golem. And to be fair, most of the time he's 75% or more to knock him down. So it's not crazy that he's knocked him down nearly every time. No, he's moving around. Absolute madman. Tell you what, I'd really like 2 whites with guard. Right about now. Just quietly. I'd quite like 2 fucking whites with guard. Holy shit. Well, to be fair, I think the strength blitzer did mangle the flesh golem. But yeah, pretty much nothing. They haven't been as influential as they could have been, shall we say. I actually had a 70 TV advantage in Armto, would you believe? Of course, that's quickly evaporated. But, you know, I've only made, like, four Claw Mighty Blow hits, and to be fair, made a KO and two stuns, so I can't complain that the Claw hasn't worked. It's just he hasn't given me the chance to use it, and obviously being down players much of it, I haven't had my own guard to even do a lot. Now at least he's going to hit with the one with dodge then, so he might not knock him over. Push me nearer the ball. Oh, of course he gets the power. Sorry. I'm sorry for thinking that a blodge player might not get knocked over. He's regen. Thank God. And that even makes the screen for this guy coming through. I don't think I'm going to do anything now. Seven players. Oh, not eight. Seven players. Think it's done. So go for the power here. No, go for the power here. Yeah, good. And now the question is, what's easier, the 6 plus or the 3-4-4-3? Well, I'm pretty sure a 6 plus is better. I'll just get my wolf killed. Maybe I should just put these two in a 2 dice tin. I guess I should have done that first, eh? Yeah, that's true, Carlo Ancelotti. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, Samba action calculator. I'll link you up. Yeah, man. What TV? It depends, Kyle, dude. I think I'm going to get a sub for my Chaos team now, like 13. 13-10. Can't believe he killed my wolf. It's a long game, isn't it? Jesus fucking Christ. 4 minute turns. How has he taken 2 minutes for this? I started my turn with a 5+ roll, and my next roll was a 6+ roll. And then he decides to take 2 minutes. Like, how can I shut down this threat of no players? That's so dangerous that he has to start his turn with a fucking 5+ roll. Jesus fucking Christ. Oh my God, why wasn't this? This league should be 2 minutes, fucking 4 minutes. I forgot it was 4 fucking minutes. Maybe he'll do this turn quick. No, no, think about that, buddy. Just move some more. Was it Inarian block skills? Minute long turn so far. Quit my leagues. Especially this one, 4 minute fucking, 4 minute fucking turns. Stay mantastic. I'll give it a go, Buttmaster. I'll give it a go next season maybe. Crucial decisions, these. Make sure you use your full 2 minutes. Only hit me more. Oh, it's good. GFI is good. I should be losing one now. Put him on a clock. That's the best. That's the best in casinos when you like put a get. We need a clock. Oh, I fucking love it. I love putting the clock on people. Holy shit. Holy shit. I love putting the clock on people in casinos. I feel like conceding just so he doesn't get a 3-star player point. Must move every single player. No, no, to be fair, less chance of making one turn. To be fair, though, if I... yeah, I could be a threat. There's two ways of looking at it, innit? There's two ways of looking at it. Is in one way, you know, if you think you're better than them, you want them at full strength so that they can... so that they can... take points off your rivals. But, you know, so there's two ways of looking at it. On the other hand, you might think if they're a rival for the title, then obviously you want to fuck them up as much as possible. So there's two ways of looking at it for it being in a league. What I did was, I was in a game, I think it was my UKBBL match, my first one. He started fouling me, so I fouled him back. Because, you know, you can't let people foul you in a league, can you? So you can't be a little bitch in a league. You know, you got to know if people foul you, you're going to foul them back. So so I did foul him back and killed two of his Black Ops, which is pretty funny. Yep, fouling did reduce the one-turn touchdown chance. So. Yeah, it's absolutely fair. I'm not gonna get mad at someone fouling me. There's no tackle this side or that side. Silly boy. Could he have put tackle there? Probably. Maybe not actually. Right. So Dodge Man definitely wants to get the ball. He wants to blitz in there. Blitz there, push him out to there. Right, blitz, push him to there, then he push. Then I need what? One to there. He'll be here, then he goes to there. Is that right? Push him under there. Push him under there, then he'll be here. He blocks him. Right, blitz him. Push him there. Then he blocks. This has to be here. And then he'll be there. And then he'll be there. So he can go to there. I kind of need one extra player. One, two, three, four, five, six, GFI. Then he goes to there. He'll be there. He just goes to there. Then he blocks. He goes out to there. It's whether I can keep this guy here or not, isn't it? That's what I've got to think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, GFI. He goes to there. He's now here. He blocks him. He goes to there. He goes to there. He goes to there. And then he blocks and gets the third one. You only need three. Right, that should work. Yeah, the current game benefit is worth it, yeah. Oh, fucking hell. Cunt. Fucking hell. He set up as bad as possible as well with the threes in the centre. And he could have had tackle there and tackle there. So he set up badly. Oh. No. There had to be a gap somewhere, didn't there? There had to be a gap. He couldn't cover it with tackle. He couldn't. He could have just put a blitzer on the line. He could have put the rookie blitzer on the line and covered the back line with tackle. So yeah, he misplayed. He misplayed there. He should have had tacklers here. He should have had the tackle across the back line. So he fucked up there. Yeah. Yeah, he should have locked down the back line with tackle. There might even be a chance still here. Because he's still set up badly. I don't think it's much of a fucking chance. But, I'll go for it. No, it's awful. That doesn't do anything. And he did the second one as well, didn't I? And he did the second push. And then if I got the second push, he could block him forward one, then he could have blocked him, but still, it was just not going to happen. Yeah, should have got the ball first, yeah. Can't believe he got the perfect defense. After setting up in the worst, literally the worst way possible. I was still just two dice anyway. Oh, fucking hell, I played too much chaos. Sent off. Six and oh, well done, Sneaker. One on the winnings, MVP on the other fleshy, that's brilliant. So yeah. Alright. A draw. The terrible record of this team. Holy shit. Look how bad that is. 3-2-4. Fucking hell. Right. I think I'm probably just going to get a block on him. I might go guard, though, just because of all the other guards that I've got. And, might fire him now. Well, not yet. There's no need to do it now. I'll do it before I'm playing the next opponent, but I'm going to replace him with a rookie, I think. Might give him guard, just because then I'll have 5 guard. Can go up to 6 pretty quickly. That was a horrible match, wasn't it? Fucking dwarves. Typical fucking dwarves. Well, there you go. Right. There you go, that's it. I'll put my face on for the last seconds. Oh god, it's dark. It's dark. It's still dark. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.